You designed the perfect newsletter in Canva. Now what? There's no built-in send button, and this is where a lot of people get stuck. Do you send it as an image, a PDF, host it on your website? In this video, I'm going to walk you through the best ways to send your Canva newsletter, including how to email it, host it on your website, and even monetize it if that's your goal. The first step is obviously going to be to design your newsletter in Canva. And the hardest part of all of that is honestly probably going to be choosing a template. They've got thousands of layouts for you to choose from, whether you're a fitness instructor, a business coach, a photographer, whatever your business or your organization is, you should not have a problem finding a template that fits your brand. And there are two main ways that you can design your newsletter within Canva. The first option is to create the full newsletter as one document. And this works well if you plan to send it out as an image, a PDF, or upload it to your website, which is an option that we'll talk more about in a minute. The second option is to design individual assets for your newsletter, like a header, an email signature, or content sections, so you can build the final email inside of your email marketing platform. So this works if you're using something like MailChimp, where you can drag and drop different elements to build out your newsletter. Once your newsletter is designed and customized and ready to go, you're going to want to download it as a PNG if you plan on embedding it in your email, or a PDF if you want to make sure that you have clickable links. The next step is going to be sending your Canva newsletter and sharing it with your audience, but this is where most people get stuck. Do you send it as an image, an attachment, a link? There are different options, and there really isn't a one-size-fits-all option, so I'm going to share two different ways that you might go about sharing your newsletter with your audience. The first option is going to be to send it through whatever email platform you're using. Maybe it's MailChimp, maybe it's Kit, and there are a couple of different ways that you can go about doing this. So if you designed individual newsletter elements like your header, your footer, and all of the pieces of your newsletter separately, you can go ahead and upload those to a template in your email marketing tool, or just use their drag and drop feature and design your own email that way. The second option is to insert the full newsletter as an image in the body of your email. This option is going to be the quickest and the easiest, but there are some downsides. Some email providers block images by default, so people might not be able to see your newsletter immediately when they open it. And another downside is that you won't be able to hyperlink individual elements within your design. So if you want to link your newsletter to something, you'd have to link the entire image to whatever you want people to open up. If you want more control over formatting and link accessibility, I do have another option that we're going to go over next, and that is hosting your newsletter on your website. Okay, hosting your newsletter on your own website. This is the second option for how you might go about sharing your Canva newsletter with your audience. And this concept might be new to you. Maybe you've never heard of hosting a newsletter on a website, but more and more entrepreneurs and creators are doing it this way instead of relying on an email platform. And there are lots of reasons why. There's tons of benefits. So the first one being you have full control over the format and the design of your newsletter and the experience that your readers are going to have. Like we talked about, there's definitely some limitations with uploading a Canva file to an email. With uploading it to your website, you can actually embed the file so all your links stay clickable, unlike email images. Another benefit is that your content is going to be easier for subscribers to access. Instead of getting lost in their inbox, your newsletter becomes part of an organized content archive on your website so people can revisit your past newsletters really easily and browse through them all on your website, kind of like a blog almost, and be able to see your content that way versus scrolling back through their email and trying to find past newsletters and your most recent one and all of that. It's just much more organized. Third, your emails stay short and more effective. So instead of sending a long email newsletter, all you'll do is send a teaser with a link to the full newsletter that would link out to your website. Lastly, you can monetize your newsletter. So it's really easy to charge for premium access to your newsletter and archives if that's something that you want to do in the future. So how would you go about setting up a newsletter on your website? The first step is going to be to upload your newsletter to a new post on your site You can use WordPress, Squarespace, Wix, whatever you want. It doesn't matter. The second step is going to be to use a tool like MemberSpace to restrict access to subscribers only. So you want to make sure that you lock those pages so the public is not getting access to all of your newsletters, but just your subscribers. The third step is to decide how you want your subscribers to access your content. So is it going to be a free newsletter and you just require an email to sign up, or is it going to be a paid subscription? And you can set up either of these options with MemberSpace. The fourth step is to send your subscribers a short email teaser with a link to the full newsletter page. So like we talked about before, instead of sending your full newsletter in an email, you'll just send them a brief email that tells them you've launched a new newsletter and here's the link to it. Go check it out. This method really does keep your content organized and helps boost engagement and gives you room to grow if you ever want to turn your newsletter into a paid subscription. Canva isn't technically a newsletter platform, so there isn't a perfect way to send out your content to subscribers, but I hope you found the two options outlined in this video helpful. If you have any questions at all about sending out your Canva newsletters, let me know in the comments, and thanks for watching.